which part of it's like, okay, that's cool, that's cool. The other half is like, okay, that's the thing, that's the thing. All right. I do actually have some, I guess, awesome news. I'm just checking it now, because if I don't, it's gonna make me nervous. For those that don't know, in order to stay in the home that I've lived for the past 30 years since I was 4, I am trying to buy the house, and it is nerve-wracking, actually. just a little bit. So give me a second here. I got paperwork sent to me by my loan officer, and I'm looking at it right now. I'm hoping that's a good thing. He sent me another email saying, hey, we're currently in the second or the fifth phase of like where we're like. Yeah. So there's the home application submitted, applications processed, appraisal scheduled, appraisal returns, loan submitted for underwriter, underwriter reviews, loan documentation, appraisal for review. We are at the pre-closing disclosure stage where figures and terms of your loan are reviewed. I went from the underwriter reviews loan documentation to this next stage. If we get through this stage, then documents get sent out for me and mom to sign. I'm the primary owner. And then you sign documents at title company and pay remaining costs if applicable. And then, yeah, how do I put this? It still feels like if I say too much, it'll just not happen. it's a little nerve wracking. One of those situations where the rent is more expensive than the mortgage. Yep. My credit score is actually 751. Mom's credit score is 739. Our credit scores are there, so I have good credit, but the rent is, to rent in the area that I live in for just a two bedroom, minimum is $1,550. That's not accounting for heat or anything. To buy the house at a $350,000 mortgage is $1,990. So I'm spending just an extra $400 to actually have a house to put like, you know, money into, to have a basically an investment versus putting into an apartment that doesn't. Deliver OSD. Speak with the Hanar. Scan this. Go to the Hydra system in the Argos Row cluster. And investigate. Okay, how does one go back to their ship? how do I go back to my ship? Oh god. Oh, I'm looking at the wrong one. You saved the Quarian. Okay, so Ambassador Indina is going to prison. Okay, so I gotta go back to the, Okay. I screwed this up. Apparently, go in the bathroom, made my brain go boop. I'm glad we don't have a credit score where I live. Like, I see a value of the credit score, but at the same time, the way they implement it, it's just kind of like, oh. Because if you don't have any revolving credit, it's a problem. And if I get the mortgage, I'll have a revolving credit. But if I don't, I gotta get a credit card and then like occasionally buy something small and then like pay it off within that week. That way I don't get the compound interest or the simple interest.
Come on.
And it's just stuff
presenting the Quarian's evidence
nobody talks about that you should know.
Eden Prime was a major victory. The beacon has brought us one step closer to finding the conduit.
Now watch, he's gonna spin this on us, and it's just gonna be a problem.
The return of the Reapers.
You wanted proof?
There it is.
This evidence is irrefutable.
We spent 3 years just working on our credit score, and it got up to 815 before we bought our house.
And all efforts will be made to bring him into action.
Yeah, mine's more of a knee-jerk reaction, which is not the best thing to do.
The one speaking with Saren.
But it's our only option.
Who is she?
Matriarchs are powerful Asari who have entered the final stage of their lives. Revered for their wisdom and experience, they serve as guides and mentors to my people.
Isn't that
Matriarch Benezia
always
the
case, son?
Bionic, and she had many followers. She will
very different. Yeah, no, I know, SJ.
I'm more.
It's great that you guys actually had the prep
them?
Work, though. I imagine that helped out considerably.
The Reapers were an ancient race of machines.
Are your asshole family put you through this?
Then they vanished.
Yep. And then, so if you guys didn't know, I'm just going to briefly go over this because it's going to be brief. Yesterday, my Aunt Joanne passed away. She actually passed away Tuesday, but we just found out about yesterday because that side of the family, which is still connected to our family, her daughter was the one taking care of her. She was also going to work, paying rent, paying the bills. She was taking care of her mom, and it was supposed to be that she would get the house. Very similar to our situation. However, her siblings came in, broke into the house, and demanded that she leave. There's something fundamentally wrong with my family. Fundamentally wrong. Now, she's currently seeking legal counsel, and we told her that she could stay here for as long as we are here. And I don't know the state of the will. That's the only thing I don't know. But yeah, there's something fundamentally wrong with my family. Yeah. Because, fun fact, they still think I'm the black sheep. So, yeah. Yeah. But they're like, you're getting out of the head. Like, they told Cheryl that she has 2 days to leave the house. If she's still within the house, then big things are going to happen. So, that's a whole thing. We found out about it yesterday, and I thought it was our neighbor next door because they both have daughters named Cheryl. So, yeah. Yeah. Because Cheryl is stepsister, half-sister, and because she's only half, they don't view her as a full blood. It's really bad. So we told Cheryl that if she needs a place to stay, she can stay up here for as long as we're in the house or we have the house. So that's totally happening. And keep in mind, this is the woman, Aunt Joanne. While I didn't really know her too much, and she was kind of rude. She was very like direct, blunt, and not always in a good way. But when we had the funeral for Grams, she was the one that came up to me and said, like, if we get kicked out of the house because of the family acting the way they are, we could come to her house and live until we got our footing. But she passed away recently and suddenly, so yeah. Invasion of privacy, breaking and arguably putting her safety at risk. Calling the police is the minimum. Going unattached by my cousins, but I've had to put up a fight. Yep. So her mom originally, married, so Joanne married my grandmother's brother, Bob, then had the two kids, right? Got divorced, but she's, because of the two kids, she stayed a part of the family for like 40 some odd years, right? Remarried, had another kid, and the eldest is just the one that's like directing all of this hate at Cheryl. So yeah, there's something wrong with her. the police moment they stepped on the property. Well, she did. And so that is a whole thing. Now they haven't actually read the will yet, so legally Cheryl might be entitled to it once they actually have the will. The eldest is acting like she can do whatever the hell she wants. And so Cheryl was amassing money. So her mom started giving her money because she flipped over to being a caregiver. She has $20,000 saved up into her account. Her oldest, her older sister, who's the executor of the will, said that you will give us $15,000 of that money. You get to keep $5,000, and that's it. And so she's been fighting with them on that. So, yeah, it's like that's her money. That's hers. So, yeah, I just little sidebar here, chat, and actually YouTube, if you're watching, a lot of things have been happening in my life in a very, very short amount of time, in such a way that it almost feels like a spin or fabrication, but I don't know if I should continue to keep telling you guys about the shit that happens in my life right now, because this is over what, less than 60 days that all of this happened and continues to happen. So hopefully you guys know me. It just, even when I say it out loud, it sounds absolutely crazy, right? Right? Freaking mental, right? Yeah. Anywho, when it rains, it pours. My grandmother's cancer came in. It was my mother who took care of her and then even paid most of the bills. When she died on her brother's, Manning his part for the inheritance, my mother just sent him the hospital bills and the hours she spent taking care of him. Good. Your mom's son sounds like a total badass and a lovely person. So, yeah, anywho.
The Geth believe the
that was the short of it, Chad.
Saren is the prophet for their return.
We think the conduit is the key to bringing them back. Saren's searching for it. That's why he attacked Eden Prime.
Do we even know what this conduit is?
Trouble.
Saren thinks he can bring back the Reapers. That's bad enough.
Listen to what you're saying. Saren wants to bring back the machines that wiped out all life in the galaxy? Impossible.
My grandchild, my grandbrother.
Where did the Reapers go? Why did they vanish? How come we found no trace of their existence?
A lot of the furniture from her house that was stuff to go to us. I really don't get how a certain family can just... Everything's hunky-dory. Or like you haven't seen them. In our case, we haven't seen most of these people in 15 years. We've made attempts. Like, hey, you want to come up for the holidays? Or do you want us to come down? And they either stopped responding or said some awful things or just ignored us. And so, where I'm at.
I tried to warn you about Saren and you refused to face the truth. Don't make the same mistake again. This is different. You proved Saren betrayed the Council. We all agree he's using the Geth to search for the conduit, but we don't really know why.
The Reapers are obviously just a
Well, either way, then, at least, you know.
A convenient lie to cover Saren's true purpose. A legend
by the sounds of it, at least
to bend the Geth to his will.
Got taken care of. Worst part is that it put it all in storage and didn't pay on it. Yeah, that makes it even worse. It's like, you stupid dumbass. It almost sounds like what he was trying to do is do a bulk sale. The sale fell through. Didn't want to deal with it, but didn't want anyone to have it, and so he punked out.
50,000 years ago, the Reapers wiped out all galactic civilization. If Saren finds the conduit, it will happen again.
Saren is a rogue agent on the run for his life. He no longer has the rights or resources of a Spectre. The Council has stripped him of his position.
You don't think he's been planning this ahead of time?
Not good enough. You know he's hiding somewhere in the Traverse. Send your fleet in!
A fleet cannot track down one man.
A Citadel fleet could secure the entire region, keep the Geth from attacking any more of our colonies.
Or it could trigger a war with the Terminus systems. We won't be dragged into a galactic confrontation over a few dozen human colonies.
So, what if it was your colonies? Would you think the same thing?
Would you feel the same way?
It's a very weird argument of, like, I get not wanting to start a war, but they're already... What's in the Terminus sector is mostly Geth, right?
Every time humanity asks for help, you ignore us.
Shepard's right. I'm sick of this council and its anti-human bull...
Ambassador.
Ambassador.
There is another solution. A way to stop Saren that does not require fleets or armies.
No, it's too soon. Humanity is not ready for the responsibilities that come with joining the Spectres.
Okay, can we just be honest about this? They don't want to help us. They don't want us to do anything either. But at the same time, they're like,
obviously, a fleet can't find one person, but one person can find one. It's one and one. Get it? Get it? Ah, yeah, you get it.
Because I'm a Spectre, he's a Spectre, we'll be able to find Spectres.
Science. Bad. Science. Took our car, called it very rare, and let it sit until no longer ran, then sold it for super cheap. Get it, he could have gotten house payment for it?
Wow.
If I go and genocide a few of your colonies, then it's fine. For all no reason, we're going to start over colonies. Yeah. Have I played this game before? Yes. But, been a while. Primary thing here, son. It has been... I haven't played Renegade. The SJ and a few of the older people that have been around the channel, they remember some of my choices. And to be fair, they were supposed to be good choices. They came out to be bad choices. So when we're going in bad, I might get good choices. Yeah.
It was a Turian Spectre who betrayed this council. And it was a human who exposed him. I have earned this.
This is the end of the universe. I just sent them everyone back to the Stone Age, that's all. And separated them by mass distances.
Commander Shepard, step forward.
Addison's like, you go, girl. You get that Spectre status. Yes. Yes, in a way, I probably just completely shattered. I mean, genetically speaking, it's very diverse. All the planets now. I imagine there's not going to be. Should be diverse enough to keep everything going.
Fire of service and battle. Those whose actions elevate them above the rank and file.
Spectres are an ideal.
He got
symbol.
Thrown through a lot of shit. All right, then the Rachni Wars were very brutal on Shepard.
Right,
I think he was even. I think that's where he was in.
Spectres bear a
or the first contact war, or a
they
war.
Are protectors of galactic peace, both our first and last line of defense.
Galactic peace through anything necessary, until we say otherwise, or we get blamed and then we throw your ass out.
This is a great accomplishment for you and your entire species.
You know what? If they ever do a remake, BioWare, you have to give us one option. One sole option. No. And then we just cut straight to credits. We get to see, like, what happens. Like, maybe something ominous showing up on the Earth or behind the Citadel right there. That's it.
I've been ready for this since Eden Prime.
We're sending you into the Traverse after Saren. He's a fugitive from justice, so you are authorized to use any means necessary to apprehend or eliminate him.
Any idea where to find him?
We will forward any relevant files to Ambassador Udina.
This meeting of the council.
Best thing for joke. Yes, it was. I mean, his animal magnetism, SJ, was very strong.
Congratulations.
I don't know how or why. Actually, because they would always remark me like, you're handsome. It's like,
you'll get access to special equipment and training. You should go down to the CSEC Academy.
Okie dokie.
Speak to the Spectre Requisitions Officer.
Anderson, come with me. I'll need your help to set
guy that looks like
up.
He was in his 50-something, maybe 60-something.
Bastard didn't even thank you.
Figures.
What do you expect from a politician? Come on.
Right behind you, Shepard.
Spectre bonus. Talent unlocked. Oh, I forgot that actually was a... They give you a talent.
Spectre training. Elite agents with the council and Spectres have access to special training available. Unavailable. Any other. Oh, okay. Unity. Please.
That's gonna keep me alive, please. Now, I remember hacking being really broken in this game. Let's see if it's still broken. All right, so we gotta get to the ports. We have not found. I went the wrong direction. We haven't interacted. Well, we did interact with Garrus just a little bit, but we haven't actually gone to him. I'm wondering what happens if we don't. Meet him at the Alliance docking bay. C-Sec Academy. Okay.
I get the feeling they're not used to seeing Krogan walking around up here.
Probably not, actually. Now, chat, keep a lookout. I'm counting on you. For any reporters, let me know. Where? Crap. Biscuits. Read signs, very good here. No, that's to the wards. Okay. Trying to figure out where we go. Is it? Do I go up? Try to get to the port. That's the Presidium. Center elevator?
Congratulations.
Oh! He's gonna force it.
I'm glad somebody got the council to see Saren for what he really is.
I told you. Chat, did I not tell you? I didn't. Mm-hmm. They're gonna be like, you're not leaving Garrus. Okay, you don't leave Garrus. Garrus leaves you. You do.
One thing I almost always think about in sci-fi with Spec Ops is that so much tech, you can make almost any normal human a badass. And why recruit from the most physically able and not uplift the most clever and loyal?
Well, to be honest, with this version of Shepard, she is loyal, but hyper violent. Not really clever. So, more like throwing a very blunt object at a situation.
What do you want?
I resigned from CSEC after the council ignored my investigation. I was sick of all the politics. You're the only one who seems to be doing anything about Saren. Let me come with you.
Like, Garrus would almost seem like to be a better alternative for a Spectre compared to, like, Shepard in general. Just in general for Shepard, right?
You're a Turian. Why do you want to bring him down?
I couldn't prove it in my investigation, but I knew what was really going on. Saren is a traitor to the Council and a disgrace to my people.
Why does she keep going with the Turian, like, angle? Like, does she not realize that they're all bad humans? This is not Star Trek. We're like, actually, no, even in Star Trek, they're bad humans. No.
I don't want you on this mission.
I'll be here if you...
You can actually say no to Garrus? I thought he was going to fight me on it. Okay. I'm going to hard save this because I don't know what's going to happen.
In light of the recent attack on Eden Prime, many colonial investors...
Think of a jock and then think of a nerd or maybe someone like yourself and ask, would you rather be a super soldier?
Human colonization insist that Eden Prime was an isolated case. Nevertheless,
as odd, like...
has dropped sharply. Many colonial proposals are on
Captain
hold
America.
Until backers have some reassurance that human colonies will be adequately protected.
There is a situation in Captain America where, Cap is talking, before he becomes Cap, is talking to the scientist, right? And, like, a jock or a bully has always known, or I shouldn't say bully, but a jock has always known strength. But somebody that hasn't known strength knows the value of strength. Knows the value of compassion, empathy, and sympathy, right?
So yeah, I'd want the person that knows value, sympathy, and compassion to be the super soldier. Because if something like that is supposed to enhance anything you're doing, you know, you want to try to elevate the good bits, not the bad bits.
I've got big news for you, Shepard. Captain Anderson is stepping down as commanding officer of the Normandy. The ship is yours now.
Parting gift.
She's quick and quiet, and you know the crew. Perfect ship for a Spectre. Treat her well, Commander.
Forced retirement?
This isn't right. The Normandy belongs to you.
You needed your
You could
own
also
ship.
Not recruit Greg.
A Spectre can't answer to anyone but the Council. And it's time for me to step down.
Come clean with me, Captain. You owe me that much.
I was in your shoes 20 years ago, Shepard. They were considering me for the Spectres.
Why didn't you ever mention this?
What was I supposed to say? I could have been a Spectre, but I blew it? I failed, Commander. It's not something I'm proud of. Ask me later and I'll tell you the whole story. For now, all you need to know is...
Let's be fair, you didn't blow it.
With Saren, and he made sure the Council rejected me. I had my shot. It came...
Possible racist.
Now you have a chance to make up for my mistake.
Easiest?
Saren's not gonna get away this time.
Saren's gone. Don't even try to find him. But we know what he's after. The conduit. He's got his Geth scouring the Traverse looking for
clues. And go after the MacGuffin.
We had reports of
Bad guy will show.
System shortly before our colony there dropped out of contact, and there have been sightings around Novaria.
Find out what Saren was after on Pharos and Novaria. Maybe you can figure out where the conduit is before he does.
And the Reaper?
The Reapers are the real threat.
I'm with the Council on this one, Shepard. I'm not sure they even exist.
But if they do exist, the conduit's the key to bringing them back.
I'll be honest. Stop the realization the conduit, what a Reaper is.
Stop the Reapers from returning.
Usually, yeah, you guys know me. I like to theory craft quite a bit. I like to, like, come up with ideas, solutions, different plot directions. When I first played this game back in the day, and realizing like what the ship actually is, I was genuinely surprised. I was like, that's pretty cool. Like, who matters? Makes a better empowered person, Flash Thompson or Peter Parker? Oh, depends on the interpretation of Flash. Are we thinking